Joe Finnegan Show. On Shannonside, Northern Sound.
087 1200 900 is our text line number today. The number of people in Ireland who say they have no religion now stands at 481,388. That is a sevenfold increase in the no religion figure from 1991. Back then, the figure stood at 60,000. Now, these figures are contained in the latest census report, and it shows there are fewer Catholics in Ireland, with a decrease of almost 130,000 since 2011. And according to the data, the number of Muslim people in Ireland increased by 28.9% to over 63,000. By the way, this region that we broadcast to, Cavan, Monaghan, Longford, Roscommon, Leitrim, Westmeath, etc., has some of the country's highest numbers who say they're Catholic. So what's really going on? Are people turning away from religion, or is there more behind the figures? David Quinn joins me on the line from the Iona Institute. And you are of the view, David, that interpretation, or how these figures are interpreted, is key here.
Yeah, because like when a person answers a census form, they're given a very top-of-the-head answer, and that applies no matter what they're saying about their religious belief or lack thereof. So obviously a lot of people who tick the Catholic box, and it's still 78%, so like it may be a drop from 84% 5 years ago, but it's still very high. Like, it's much higher than the number who tick the religion box in places like Britain or France or Sweden. Like, it's still very high by European standards. But what are they actually thinking when they're doing this? Because a lot of them would rarely go to Mass. A lot of them wouldn't subscribe to a lot of the kind of central beliefs of the Catholic Church or Christianity generally. So probably what they're saying is, well, you know, I don't mind identifying as a Catholic. I'm baptized a Catholic. I go to Mass every now and again. I go at Christmas. I go to funerals and weddings. I don't mind having my own child baptized or going to the local Catholic school. So it's probably expressing a kind of cultural Catholicism.
Yeah, but the thing is, you're either a Catholic or you're not. In the eyes of the Catholic Church, they don't have too much time, do they not, for a la carte Catholics?
Well, you see, we have Pope Francis now, and he takes a much more benign
view. He's saved the day, has he?
Of that kind of thing. But at the other end, you've got this big increase in the number of people saying, you know, ticking the no religion box. Yeah. So it's up to nearly 10% from about 6% 5 years ago. Mm-hmm. And what's going on there? You see, you know, if you look at that on the surface, and this is what I would have thought, if you've got no religion, then you are likely to be an atheist or agnostic. But it turns out that's not the case either. Because if you look at other research data, like there was a big exit poll done by RTE last year after the general election, and that was adults only, the census is everyone, and it found 14% said they had no religion. But then they asked, are you atheist or agnostic? So only 5% fell into that category. So 5% of the 14% said, I'm atheist or agnostic. And 9% described themselves as spiritual, but not religious.
Right. So they may be spiritual, and they may not be agnostic, or they may not be atheist, but they're also definitely not Catholic.
Correct. So I think, you see, there's been a lot of surveys done and studies done of the category N-O-N-E, none. Not the N-U-N, N-O-N-E-S, the nuns. A lot of them pray. Some of them do go to church every now and again. But as I say, they're in the spiritual, not religious category.
All right.
So when they say no religion, what they appear to be saying is, I don't belong to any organized religion.
All right, stay where you are, because, John, let's go to Monaghan. John Hamill is with us from Atheist Ireland, a regular contributor to the show. So you can't claim them, John. They may be saying they're not Catholic, but they're definitely not atheist or agnostic, for that matter. They're somewhere in between.
So I agree with David on both points that he made. In terms of the people who tick the no religious box, we can't be exactly clear that they're all committed atheists. And in terms of the people who tick the Catholic box, we can't be exactly clear that all of those people believe all of the tenets of Catholicism. And actually, this is pretty well understood by the CSO in terms of the flaws in the design when we compare our census to those in other countries. And actually, the flaws overstate the number of religious people in Ireland. So what the CSO does in Ireland is they ask the question, what is your religion? And then they invite people to tick a box. And what people in other countries have experienced is when they change that, to first ask a question, do you have a religion, yes or no? And then only the people they have a religion, they ask to pick a denomination. What they find is many, many more people say no, they don't have a religion. So yes, about 10% of people in Ireland now have no religion at all. And we think that that figure is significantly understated by the CSO.
Why?
There's actually quite a few more than that.
Well, let me put it to you this way. Why do you think the no religion figure is rising quite steadily?
That's reasonably clear. On the whole, people are rejecting Catholicism because it just...
No. It's not only Catholicism. They could be rejecting one of a number of religions. So don't be just pointing the finger. And by the way, Catholicism is still up there.
Are increasing. That's true, Joe. But the biggest drops are in Catholicism. And to answer your question directly, I think people are rejecting Catholicism because it's just not true. You know, it's just not true that some men can put on a pretty dress every Sunday and use special words to transubstantiate wine into the blood of a 2,000-year-old Palestinian carpenter.
Ah, now you're just getting mocking. Would you ever take the subject seriously? Like, there's an awful lot of people out there, and I mean, they take their religion seriously, and they just want people to show kind of a certain level of basic courtesy when they're talking about what's most precious to them. And you're just engaging in this kind of, you know, common...
You are being disrespectful. I mean, John, you are being disrespectful. If that is... If they have a belief in something, it is to be respected, is it not?
Yes, exactly. So, as I understand, Catholicism, what I said is exactly consistent with Catholicism teaches.
Right, but at the end of the day, whether at the end of the day, hang on,
I'm not making that up. That's
all right.
The teaching of Catholicism, that's not what I describe as the truth.
Right, but
yeah,
at the end of the
census findings.
Yeah, let me just put this question to you. At the end of the day, John, especially in this region, as I said in my introduction, the one that we're broadcasting to, five counties here, the figures in relation to those who are of the Catholic faith are massive, still in the mid to low to mid 80s.
That's true. And just to be very clear, Joe, you asked me a question, which was, why are we seeing the trends that we are? And the response that I've just received from David and yourself describe exactly why we see the trends that we are, which is, when someone says, I don't think that these beliefs are true, we're immediately told, you cannot say that, you cannot talk like that.
No, you're engaging in a common garden mockery.
What's not.
You're engaging in cheap mockery.
Well, David, let me put that question to you. What do you put it down to? For example, can I put forward this suggestion that it's typical, isn't it, of the human race, when things are bad with our lives, lifestyle, the economy, or what have you, we have to cling on to something. And I know I've had you on before during the recession when numbers were growing steadily, albeit anecdotally, and we were seeing more and more people in church and at mass because they needed something to cling on to. Now that the economy is improving, they're leaving again.
Well, I mean, I think that's part of it. I think, though, I mean, Ireland can't be immune from the general secularising trends that have taken hold in most of the Western world. So, like, we might be an island physically, but we're not an island culturally. And so we can't, you know, resist those trends forever. I mean, actually, what's kind of remarkable is if you look at there's something called the European Social Survey, and it's a very major survey conducted all around Europe every 2 years, and it also looks at the religion question, and it asks the question differently from the census, and it's adults only, because obviously adults will fill in the census for their children. So the European Social Survey is adults only, and it finds the number of people who self-identify as Catholic is 69% rather than 78%, and that the number of people who state they have no religion actually comes up to 26%, although half of them say they pray. But it also asks people, how often do you attend church? And the answer is 34% every week. And only one country in Europe has a higher level of weekly church attendance, and that is Poland. Like, if you take a place like Britain, it's vastly lower. And in Britain, the number of people who say they have no religion is 51%. In Sweden, it's 70%. So Ireland is still, by European standards, while it is increasingly a secular place, it is still a very religious place in a certain sense than these other countries. I mean, I think people kind of subscribe to a sort of, you know, Catholicism light version of the faith. They kind of believe in a God that is there to kind of turn to in times of need, as you say, is there to kind of smooth their path, but they don't believe in a very demanding version of Christianity anymore.
Right.
That kind of puts big demands on them.
All right, John, final word to you. Why do you believe, John, you live in this region, why do you believe that the "Yes, I am a Catholic" figure is still so high, probably one of the highest on the island? Why is that, in your view?
Well, I agree with David that a large part of it is cultural, but it's still changing in this region almost as quickly as it's changing everywhere else, Joe. And as I say, I think the reason why it's changing in part is because the beliefs are just so patently superstitious. I'm not really sure how else I can answer that. You know, the Bible says that Jesus was a Palestinian carpenter, but apparently I'm not allowed to say that.
It's the tone of mockery. I mean, I could engage in mockery by saying an atheist is somebody who believes nothing made everything. All right? So I can engage in kind of common or garden mockery as well.
Yes.
An atheist believes nothing made everything.
Sorry,
how is that possible?
David, sorry, that's absolutely fine. I do believe that everything came out of nothing. And I have absolutely no problem with that. But I don't know why there's a problem when I accurately describe Catholic doctrine that suddenly I'm mocking. I didn't decide that Jesus was a Palestinian carpenter. That wasn't my decision.
And you see, it's belittling rather than, I mean, look, are we here to talk about the census, or are we here to talk about the credibility
of
your beliefs and my beliefs?
Oh, well, okay, I think...
engaging in cheap mockery. I mean, it was the Gospel of Mark that Jesus was a Palestinian carpenter, it wasn't me.
I think we'll leave it at that. It's an interesting one. We'll see what our listeners have to say about it. David Quinn from the Iona Institute in Dublin, and also John Hamill from Atheist Ireland in Monaghan. Thank you for being with us on the show today. What do you think? The no religion figure is growing. 60,000 in 1991 said they had no religion. That's the 1991 census. The figure now in 2016 is close to 500,000. It has to be said, here in this region, the "Yes, I am a Catholic" figure is probably one of the highest in the country. I'm sure you have views on same. Could it be, though, maybe John Hamill has a point. Could it be that Jesus has been found out? I don't know. I'm only asking the question, and that's not me being anti-religious. We'd like to hear from you. Back in a moment.